Hello guys, this is Stelios, hope you're doing fine. Today it's story time. I'm gonna take you back to 2002. I'm around 20 years old and I'm playing guitar for 2 or 3 years. I'm mostly into punk or metal, but I'm slowly starting to get lessons and at the same time getting into instrumental guitar music. This was way before YouTube, Spotify or broadband internet connections. So any access to music and especially video footage was, at least in my case, mostly from illegal copied CDs and random collections of MP3s or MPEG videos. Well, one fateful day in one of those CDs I saw this. And then I watched it again, and again, and again. Who is this dude? And how is it possible to play like that? I've never heard a guitar make such noises. How is he getting that amazing tone? And what is that gorgeous white guitar he's playing? Turns out, his name was Steve I. I knew the name, but I wasn't expecting that. That video started it all for me, and I was hooked for life. I wanted to get better at guitar, and I wanted to sound like that, play like that, and I also wanted that white guitar that I later learned it's called a Jem. On the playing part, I'm still working on it, but that guitar was calling me. 1 year later, around 2003, after drooling over photos of it for a year, I somehow managed to convince my father to get me one. It took more than 2 months to get here, but I still remember the moment I got the phone call to pick it up from the local music store. I was in heaven. It was beautiful. It played like butter and sounded amazing. Even the store owner was amazed. He managed somehow to sell such a high-end guitar in such a small city. What can I say? I was ecstatic. I loved how that guitar looked, sounded, played, everything. It made me want to play more. It didn't feel like practice, sitting every day for 6 or 8 hours, for years. I wasn't practicing, I was having fun with my toy, basically. I did some of my first gigs with that guitar, and I also recorded 2 studio albums, one in 2005 and 2008. It was around 2006, where I also got another Ibanez, my PGM 301. Another amazing Japanese-made instrument that I still got to this day. They were quite similar, but also quite different. They felt like sisters. I still have my PGM 301, and I love it to bits. This is it. It is an amazing guitar. Made in Japan, 2006. The Jem I kept from 2003 until around 2010, until I regrettably sold it to fund another guitar. That was a very stupid thing to do, and I regretted it ever since. So years went by, and I wanted the Jem again. New ones were way too expensive, and used ones were either way overpriced, and the premium line, the Indonesian made, never really convinced me quality-wise. So basically, there's nothing better than a well-made Japanese Ibanez.
Stat.
So back to today. Around 2 weeks ago, I did a cover video, and in that video, I included some footage I found in an old VHS tape. of me playing that Jem back in 2003. I think that video kind of struck a chord, and I started thinking, what if I could locate that friend I sold that guitar to? And what if he still had that guitar? And what if he was willing to sell that guitar also? What did I have to lose? So I managed to find that friend, and turns out he still had that guitar 11 years later. And he was also willing to sell it. Plus he made me a great offer. So we met and I checked out the guitar. It wasn't in great condition, but the price was right. And yes, it is. This is the actual guitar, by the way. All original, every screw, every bolt. And she's 18 years old. But of course, there are some issues. Some things need fixing. And that's what we'll do today. Hopefully, I can get her back into her former glory. So let's do that. Thank you.
find love. Comfort, comfort, and peace, peace.